tell us about it.
Sure. So we're looking at the native interface that comes in a Regal GS. And this gives you access to a lot of information in the car, but it also has a new feature called Apple CarPlay. So we'll just launch that. And it brings us into a user experience that's very familiar to someone who
So it's
uses
an iOS phone. Ecosystem, basically, yes. In your car.
It's us bridging from the vehicle into the iOS, what's on your phone, yes. And so if you're used to using an iPhone, this is going to be instantly familiar to you. The icons are shared, you know, they look the same, and the behaviors behind them are very similar. What's different about them is they've been kind of tuned for a driving experience. They're appropriate for what's in the car. So you're not going to be able to see everything that you can see on your phone while you're driving, because that wouldn't be very safe. So it's
So why don't you punch up something and let's see what it does.
So right now we're actually listening to music coming off of Apple Music. And so this is coming in, all right, off of my phone. If I unplug this, I could go back to listening to the radio, but this is using Apple's music, and I can go through. And they've actually added today a pretty significant update to the music app within CarPlay. So they added a new tab for you, and it's able to go through, and you'll be able to see all my favorite things on here, but you'll be able to see different playlists, and it'll give you some new recommendations.
Very cool. So the new recommendations is a great idea.
Yeah. So while you're driving around, you don't have to be...
Somebody's asking about the GPS app. Is it Waze?
It's Apple Maps.
Apple Maps.
Right.
There you go.
So in here, it's going to be very familiar to...
We're in the middle of nowhere.
Well, we're near Sun Valley. If we were to, you know, get on a route, you'd see it. It'd look very familiar to what you would use on your phone if you're using it, but this is more...
Question, does this use your phone data?
Yes.
It does use your phone data, Raji.
You can, if you connect the in-vehicle hotspot, you can use the vehicle's data plan for that as well.
Okay, so you have an in-vehicle hotspot that's available on the 2016 Buick.
Correct.
And is that unlimited or is it cap data?
It's data. It's a data plan associated with your OnStar account.
Okay. So you can use the maps like all day.
Right.
Okay. Or you can hook up your phone to it.
Right.
What else do y'all want to see? Show us some of the other features.
And then another thing they added today in the iOS update is a new destination screen. So in addition, this was already here for a while.
Right.
But if you, now it adds some shortcuts in here. So if you are looking to a nearby parking, we're in the middle of nowhere, so there may not be a whole lot of parking here. Maybe we should go for a restaurant. So it's going to bring stuff up. It'll give you those recommendations with a one touch, without having to kind of go
Very
into
Very cool.
The
so yeah. There's the gas station, so you don't have to go through a menu.
Right. You still always have the ability to use Siri.
Okay. So, you can talk to Siri. Yes, yeah. Somebody just asked.
Yes. So we've actually integrated Siri into this button here on the steering wheel, so you don't have to be reaching around the car. So I hold this down.
And?
Directions to the nearest airport.
The nearest one I see is Gimlet Airport on Mackenzie Lane in Haley. Is that the one you want?
No. I want the one in Detroit.
Michelle on Lewis Street, Ketchum, about a mile to your west.
Okay,
Does
so
that
there
one
you go.
Sound good?
So it's more of a conversational background back and forth between us and Siri.
Got it.
And you notice how the music, I don't know how much you're picking up on the audio, the music went down so you can interact with the voice, and then came back up in a very nice, smooth way.
Okay, this is Apple CarPlay, mm-hmm. And is there a special app in the App Store they have to download separately?
No, this is built into iOS.
Okay, so it's built into iOS, it's a function of iOS, and it connects via Bluetooth?
Via USB. So you plug this into the USB port in the car.
Right.
And then once you've done that, you can actually put your phone away and just interact with it with the...
Very cool. Does anybody have any questions? What else can it do?
So we did a little bit of just general Siri, if I were to go into here, it'll
to whom should I send your message?
Phil Colley. And it will start
in one of these, Philip Colley the Second, or Phil Abram.
So it can
what do you choose. Want to say to Philip Colley the Second?
When are we going to get lunch?
Your message says, when are we going to get lunch? Ready to send it?
Yes. So again, in a very natural conversational way, you can interact with, you can stay in touch with your friends without having to have something that's a little bit more inappropriate for driving.
And you can press something on the...
Right, there's a voice button right here.
Voice button right there.
Right.
So it's not voice activated, you get to press it.
Right.
Oh, yes, I do, but give me a question for the AppleFly. We have people from France here.
Right.
Does it have iPhone calendar and notification capability?
No.
No.
So you that stuff you want to keep on your phone. We really haven't, working with Apple, we really haven't come up with a really appropriate way to use that while you're driving.
Okay, and last thing, any features you want to mention about how you've enjoyed the ApplePlay experience?
We just got a text message. That's what it looks like when you have an incoming text message. I use it quite often. On a regular day-to-day basis, I use it for... I especially like listening to podcasts, and so...
What's the MLB.com?
So there's a number of apps on here. I've got a few on here, but this is... MLB's network. I'm a baseball fan, so
am I.
It'll bring up the available audio streams for the games that are in progress right now. It's bad doing a demo in the morning when it's not there
yet. Can Siri read your
text
message and will it reply using voice?
Using voice. So I just got a voice message. I got a message from Phil. It came out if I had tapped on the notification, it would have taken me there. Here it will check for messages.
Would you like to hear your unread messages or create a new one?
Unread messages.
Philip said, whenever you want. Hi, Marcia's Periscope audience. Would you like to reply?
We've got Raji on from Dish Nation, the TV show.
Okay.
Good to see you, Raji. We're going to have to get you a test on this, too.
Right. But to finish off the MLB, I mean, none of those games show up because there's no games in progress right now.
Yeah, right. I get it.
But there's a number of other apps that, and pens that you would have to have installed on your
On your phone, right.
So if you have, like, I listen to Overcast, but if you have, like, iHeartRadio, you can go in there and get your favorite digital radio stations from, like, out of market. You can get
or my computer and technology radio podcast.
There
would
you
be
go.
On there.
There you go. So, there's a number of different apps on there. There's more than these particular five. These are just ones that I use on a regular basis. So, because we are using my phone. But they just extend the experience for it so you can bring those into your car.
Thank you. Thank you so much for explaining this. Everybody's wanted to see it.
Okay.
Thank you, everybody, for stopping by and taking a look at our cast.